welcome the highlights of the third day's play of the fifth test match at Trent Bridge. A day which began with Australia very much on top. First day they didn't lose a wicket, and they started this third day with Border on 46 and Ian Healy on 5. Conditions were good, a little bit of a cloud cover out there at the start of play. The thought once again that the ball might swing. We're going to join play now in the first over. It's Fraser coming into bowl to Ian Healy from the pavilion end, and there's been no addition to the overnight score, 560 for 5.
And now it's 560 for 6. Ian Healy plays on. No addition to the overnight score. Border remains the non-striker's end on 46.
Well, a bit of good fortune for Fraser. He's been unlucky on numerous occasions, but on that time, just inside edge, chopped back onto the stumps. Again, that ball just bounced a little higher. You see it above the stumps, then chopped down with that leg stump.
Trevor Hones is the new batsman. Look for two there, but Fraser's the man coming in quickly. Oh dear me, don't tell me he's done something to his knee.
Well, that really would be bad news for England if Fraser did anything to the knee, because Botham's already off with that dislocated finger, which is swollen this morning. Straightforward, a little bit of fielding and no need to really twist or anything. It was just coming straight towards the ball, no real twisting. But the foot just went into the turf there.
Well, that is very bad luck for Angus Fraser. Just hope that it's nowhere near as serious as it looked when they saw that ankle turn over. Two to Border and 50 to Border. But he hasn't been quite as dominant this tour as he was in 1985. But he's done it quite beautifully from the tactical point of view on many occasions.
Oh, that's luck. Over the slips. It's 4 runs. And that's the declaration. That's exactly what he wanted, the psychological barrier, really, of 600. 602 he's got. And that's going to leave England an awkward 55 minutes batting before lunch.
It certainly does, and that is a massive total there for the Australians. They made 601 at Headingley before they closed, and now the follow-on figure is over the 400 mark. That is a daunting task at which England look coming in for those 55 minutes. 219 for Taylor, and today Border finished on 65. The bowling figures: Atherton, no wicket, 3 to Cook, none to Hemmings, none to Botham, 1 to Malcolm, who I thought bowled much better than those figures, and the same goes for Fraser, who finished with 2 for 108. So a long way to go for England. Here's the first ball of their innings. Curtis is taking strike, and Terry Alderman is the bowler.
That's a pretty positive start. Only a single, but the crowd roared in relief. He's out, he's gone. Delivery seeming away, snapped up, and there's a sad start for England. Tragedy for Moxon. Fine piece of bowling by Alderman yet again, and England 1 for 1.
Well, just thinking the ball hadn't really swung, but that one went beautifully. Nothing much Moxon could do really about that. It was bowled very, very straight, just a little outside edge and just carrying to slip.
Well, in at the deep end for Mike Atherton. What a position. 601 runs adrift, a wicket in the first over. Your first test match, capacity crowd, and you're in. Yeah. Oh, and he's given in. He's given in. Well, what a start. Atherton looks and goes. Atherton well forward. Only question was, had he got outside the line? Umpire Clues says no. A score line of 1 for 2.
Well, I don't think you can get outside the line to a straight ball. And that ball was pitching round about middle stump. And it just held and it kept down. Robin Smith coming out now, but a bit of tension. Barely had time to get the pads on. But really, what an object lesson to bowlers, to the older man is. Is what you were taught to do as young kids in my day. You got close to the stumps, you bowl wicket to wicket, and you bowl with a good action, and the ball just went away from the right-hander. And he's a perfect example of it. A really marvellous piece of bowling by Alderman. From the crowd. Well, Robin Smith has admitted he's had problems in getting too far of the offside and falling over. And you can see there the position of the head. And that pulls the body over. He got out caught down the leg side in the last match. It's a little bit unlucky, but it comes about because your head is going too far to the offside and pulling the weight of the body then over with you.
That's a better stroke. The front foot placed inside the line of the ball, allowing room for the bat to flow forward. Basic stuff. Oh, dear, dear. Well, it was a no ball, but it was a cracking delivery. Just whizzed back off the seam.
Yes, I think Terry Alderman has made real good use of that ball when he probably just turns the shine round and pushes it into the right-hander. He seems to have improved as the tour's gone on. I don't think the shout of no ball would have made any difference.
That's a firm reply. Well, it raises a cheer.
Robin Smith's not being dictated to. If the ball's there to be hit, he's certainly put back to ball. And that's the correct thing to do. You've got to play normal cricket.
Jeff Lawson to Tim Curtis. Oh, that must be close.
Smile from David Shepherd. I think there could well have been a little inside edge there. Again, we saw the bat coming across from slips to mid-wicket. I think possibly just a little nick on, maybe just missing the leg side. But look where the bat finishes. That bat is facing now straight to mid-wicket.
Oh, didn't carry. A sketchy single.
Well, Jeff Lawson causing just as many problems as Terry Alderman. And that was a good delivery. That was angled in and then seamed away off the wicket and caught the outside edge.
Dear me, that is as plumb as you're likely to see ever.
Well, throughout his short innings, Curtis has played very much across the line of the ball. The bat going from the slips towards mid-wicket, and there's no better example of that. Right in front, the bat going from about third slip to mid-wicket, and once again we're seeing the edge of the bat. And that really is a fault of basic technique.
David Gower, the England captain, comes out. It's 14 for 3.
This is a great shout from the Australians. Terry Alderman there getting swing and the ball hitting about pad roll. So I should think the only possible decision that Nigel Plews has got to make there is the ball a little bit high.
Well, 30 for 3. Two or three balls since lunch. No further disasters yet. And Robin Smith in confident form has come out prepared to play shots. You'll get 3 runs for that. Oh, and has he dropped it or hasn't he? No, he hasn't. He's claiming the catch. Gower has to go. Fumbled by Healy, but he recovered in time. Wild slash from David Gower, and now England really on the ropes. 37 for 4 with Gower caught by Healy. Off the bowling of Lawson for 11.
Well, it was in there that David Gower has been dismissed so many times. What is it with an angled bat? Just that little bit of extra bounce. Came out and Healy certainly did very, very well to catch that in his left hand at the finish, but it was a typical David Gower dismissal.
Now, does Ian Botham come in? There's a triumphant Lawson. And in fact, it's Jack Russell. Going forward, back foot going across, looking to play it square, a little bit of bounce into Healy's gloves, out, and then the plunge forward, and in the end a good piece of wicket keeping. For England. Applause of relief more than appreciation, I think. And that's a good shot. That's a good shot.
Yeah, Alderman just pitching a little short, but Russell's very quick to just get on that back foot, and really it's just a little swat away shot. It's no more than that. Short back lift, just helping it on its way.
There was slow spin there for Eddie Hemmings and Nick Cook. Same will apply for Trevor Hearns. He'll turn the ball a little, but it'll be very slowly. And that hit the stumps.
Interesting to see whether this ball actually goes from Jack Russell's gloves onto his leg. Yes, and rolls and definitely hits the stump there.
There are plenty of unsung heroes in touring teams. I reckon you're looking at one now. Third seam bowlers always have problems of recognition. But Merv Hughes has done a splendid job so far in this tour, back up to Alderman and Lawson. All three have stayed fit, which has been a great thing for Australia. But Hughes has allowed Border to keep up the attack all the time. And sometimes the batsman can reply. A lovely shot.
Robin Smith here making room by getting back onto that back foot, again using full use of his height, up onto the toes there as he makes contact with the shot, and the head really on line with the ball, watching where the ball's going to go towards the boundary.
Another nice shot, beautiful timing. No chance of cutting that off. Successive boundaries for Smith.
Nothing worse for a bowler than when the ball strays offside to start with. It's hit to the boundary, square of the wicket, and then you try and get your line just that little bit straighter, and the ball drifting away down the leg side, and Robin Smith using the pace of the ball there from the delivery to make sure that it gets to the boundary.
That's not a good straight drive. Robin Smith's speciality today is just weighed onto that front foot. Rather punchy follow through of the bat. And that's the 50 partnership between Jack Russell and Robin Smith. Oh, that's brilliant. Quite extravagant. What a way to get to 50. Well, you wouldn't think that England are in trouble, would you? You'd think that it's a Sunday match at Southampton. Another great shot from Robin Smith, and England have the handle up. An innings which began with absolute disaster. And there were 3 wickets down for 14, 4 wickets for 37. Now we've seen a 50 partnership and more between Robin Smith and Jack Russell. And after Merv Hughes gets hammered, 4 overs, no maidens, 0 for 31, Australia now turn to Geoff Lawson.
Oh, look at that for a shot. Just flicked away. 3 more for Smith. Oh, that's well bowled. He's got to go. Russell knows. He didn't even look. Lawson breaks through, and the end of a gallant little innings of 20 from Russell. England 119 for 5.
Great joy here for the Australians, a really vital wicket this, because they know Jack Russell, once he's in, plays exceptionally well, but this time, not one of Jack's better shots. Tempted to play a little bit away from his body there, not really playing an attacking shot, so defensively he'd be disappointed. He'd have felt he could have played that back down the wicket. But Jack Russell out for 20.
Eddie Hemmings, the new batsman. Ian Botham still not batting. Hit him immediately, everybody round him, and just look at the impact of this smash from Robin Smith, who's hitting the ball as hard as he's ever done.
You can just see there that the ball has hit him on the side of the head, and it has in fact knocked the helmet off.
Tough little character that's from 3 yards range, when you get a ball hit that hard, he can still smile, he can still walk, and he wants to be thankful for that. There's Tom Moody, the 12th man, who's come on instead of Boone. Fine shot from Hemmings, that's the place not to bowl at him. Any sort of width, and he can play that sort of shot. That'll be two or three. He'll be looking for three to keep the strike. And getting it. 150 up for England. 92 of those to Robin Smith. In second successive innings where he's scoring a terrific percentage of England's overall runs. He's gone for it and got it, and that's a magnificent 100 for Robin Smith, getting there with his 16th boundary. Applause from the balcony, applause from the crowd, and applause from his partner and the Australian players. Really has been a wonderful counter-attack by Smith, his second 100 of the series.
Tory Alderman is back, the ball to Robin Smith. And that is out, the 101. Alderman comes back and almost automatically takes a wicket. Robin Smith, caught by wicketkeeper Healy, going across a long way. That was a marvellous innings from Robin Smith, 101 out of 172, and he will thoroughly deserve the standing ovation that will come his way.
Robin Smith playing a very fine innings for England, but he'd be very disappointed with that shot because the ball very, very wide. But I suppose as a viewer and a spectator, if it had gone flashing to the boundary, we'd have said, what a wonderful shot. But there, just a nice loosener from Terry Alderman. The ball, in fact, it did swing. Angus Fraser coming into bat.
Every run is absolutely vital for England here this afternoon. They've got to get up as close as they can to that follow-on mark. And there's four more.
The wicket has shown a little bit of uneven bounce, and on this occasion the ball going quite low, hitting the outside edge there and going between the slips and gully away to the boundary.
That's a great shot. Well, that's the way I like to see tail-enders bat. Give it a bit of wood.
A really amazing shot here from Eddie Hemmings. Real power coming in, and the one thing you can say about that, if you are going to strike out, hit straight.
That's England's 200. Nice mid-wicket boundary. If only that was true, 303 for six, but I think they're due to get 100 back. That might have carried to Jones.
Yes, it just carried a sharp chance, but I'm disappointed at not catching that.
That's bowled him, dragged it on. Really, it couldn't last. Fine innings, and nice to see him bat that way, but the end of Hemmings dragging one on from Alderman. Out for 38 in England, 214 for seven.
Yes, that was well wide. He's played this shot on four or five occasions and the ball's gone to mid-wicket. On that occasion, he got a thick inside edge and just dragged it onto the stump. But Nice innings there from Eddie Aries.
10th time that Terry Alderman has taken 5 wickets in an innings for Australia. And the 5th time in this series.
Funny game this, you can play for half an hour sometimes and not get off the mark. Another time you just play forward like that, the ball runs off the thick edge, past second slip and 4 runs.
And there he goes, Hones has picked up the wicket. Good tactics from Border to bring him on.
Watch this ball turn back in, it's the googly. Angus Fraser also getting a little inside edge there, but really good captaincy by Alan Border.
Nick Cook is the new batsman. Oh, well caught. Well caught, that was a sharp catch. So Hones has picked up another one, and the ploy of having both of them take him hasn't worked, and it's the 9th wicket down. And that's the way it stayed so far as wickets were concerned, but they did add another 2 runs in the 1.5 overs bowled from that point up to the close of play. Incidentally, David Boone, who was struck by Robin Smith at short leg, is okay. He had to leave the field, and they thought he might have had a little bit of concussion, but he's absolutely fine. Robin Smith, a marvellous innings of 101. The latter order played well, but disaster up the top for England in that 246 for 9. The bowling, Terry Alderman dominating it again with 5 for 69. Jeff Lawson bowled well, 2 for 57, and Trevor Hones, 2 for 39. So at the close of play on the third day of this Cornhill Test match, Australia 602 for 6, England 246 for 9, 356 behind, and they need another 157 to avoid the follow-on. Well, I thought today, I was watching a replay of Old Trafford a couple of weeks ago. Robin Smith made 143 up there and dominated proceedings. He did the same here today. It was absolutely magnificent performance. We leave you with him tonight. He's a very bright spot in England's cricket at the moment.